Okay, we're most of the way out to the warming shelter, our 9 mile ride out to that, and then more of the fun begins. I'm on my long track today, 137. Got 5 snow bikes. I think the other two are with us. Just trying to get used to this long track. I haven't ridden it much at all this winter. It's a good test, I guess. Some nice fresh snow. Group is on an all-new mountaintop snow bike track, one of the few that's out on the snow this year. There he is right there, just looking at it. It's pretty sweet. I want to get on it, see if it lives up to the hype. He was saying the ski does really well on icy junk. It goes straight, unlike the timber sled ski, but says it will dart around some on the choppier trail like we've got right now. But my quiver ski here, the Nemesis, what was that I hit? The Nemesis, it goes straight on ice too. It doesn't really dart at all. All right, I am on the mountaintop, as in mountaintop kit. Sweet. Feels pretty good. The ski is a little washy. And he definitely has it set up different than I have my bike set up, but hard to get to the shifter. Definitely is nimble. Seeing if it trenches. Ski's feeling better now. I added some pressure. I don't know why my Air Pros have been losing pressure. I need to track that down. But the first part, I wasn't feeling too good. And then add the pressure, it's night and day. I felt like that ski on the mountaintop there was a bit washy. But it, some of it had to do with, I think, the setup. He's sitting back. A lot of people ride their snow bike sitting farther back, you know, like a low rider. Ooh, T-post. And I ride a little bit more pitched forward. All right, so yeah, we're back together, 5 of us. Nice to have a girl with us. Women on a snow bike, not a lot of them. I think more women should ride snow bike. It takes way less upper body strength, and it's easier to steer than with so many women on sleds. It's just such a difficult thing for him to really tug that sled around and get it turned of a snow bike. It's a way to go. Pretty tracked up in here. Doesn't matter for us. I think we're heading for that more pristine zone up there. A lot of snow bikers really like the lively wheelie feeling and jumping off of stuff. That's not something for me. So I don't know, I'm not a Riot kind of guy. I want something that's gonna get me through stuff in a safe way, take me about anywhere I want to go. Snow bikers go. Whoa, that is so hard. And some hard chunks every once in a while. We haven't gotten a lot of new snow, so. Wow, we really need trail techs. These snow bikers are hard to follow. This right here is the aftermath of a tornado. All this right in here. Undocumented tornado. It's this whole swath through here. This 137 is great. Boys are up there. Half pipe. Snow coverage is pretty good up here. This drainage is notorious for handling some. There they are. Oh yeah. Oh, he's down. Too much wheeling going on up there. Guys are so much better than when I was snowbiking before they started, and so I saw them when they were first ever on snow bikes, and they were good then, but now they're so much better. Yes, this 137 climbs so good. It only takes till the end of February to get deep enough snow to ride it. It's all right, next week actually looks like it's gonna keep piling on. China Ditch gets another person. This is China Ditch. Yeah.
I thought so. I found the bottom of it.
I saved my friend's life in this ditch once.
What happened?
He flipped upside down and his sled was pinning him down.
Oh,
took us like 5 minutes to find him and we had to pull it off of him. And then my other friend, we life flighted off the other side. So twice. You gotta, don't mess with this thing. We got some surface whore. Yeah. Good test slope for avalanches. All right, there they are. Snow is magnificent in here. Somehow we always end up in the same spot even when we get separated, so maybe we don't need those expensive things that we can't get because they're not available. Last time I was in here, I was having fuel issues from that god-awful RPM-driven fuel tank. You wash out there?
Yeah, I just came fucking bombing in and hitting my stupid
my truck just went whoop.
Dude, that's a good jump right here.
Starting to warm up. I think the snow's getting sticky. Been in this meadow yet. Snow bikers have now. Snow is much better in here. Starting to get kind of sticky where the sun was hitting over there. Just on a climb there and had my bike just cut out on me. I don't know if the tether came off, but not normal. I'm a little worried there, like, I don't know. It's weird. Just was throttling it and stopped. It's possible to. Where'd the other two go? Oh, is that a rock? It's something there. Pillows are all covered up. Looks a little more filled in than I was expecting. Sweet. Bad. Oh, felt that. That's how you do it. Nice. I think we realized, instead of being barely legal, we were barely illegal. So we had to take a quick turn. It's kind of tough in here. It's like not a line that follows a drainage. It's kind of a straight line. So, whoa! Nice! So anyway, like, winter time. I know some people that have gotten tickets for being up there. It's a rock showing. Such a nice day. Creek bottom. Basically, we've got most of the kits represented out here. I guess no rail, but I mean, they're all pretty similar, really. I've ridden all of them except for, I've never ridden a rail, but used to come in here and it was like a major deal with a sled to get from there to over there. It's like nothing. Snowbike. actually still shows. Used to be a big deal to come up this thing. Oh, fence post. Oh, I think I felt one. That is the biggest BS fence ever. Trying to keep cattle out of the wilderness. It doesn't work at all. Yeah, this used to be, I remember spending down at the bottom of this hill, spent half a day once trying to get a sled out of there. My, how things have changed. Well, for one, I have no problem getting a sled out of there, but with the snow bike, all this stuff is easy. Is that the same spot you were, Tanner?
Yeah.
Just got sucked into that. Yeah, that's me. You were, I think that was where you were at. You think so? Because I'm sitting in the sun?
I try to every time I sit.
Yeah, that works. If you get going straight and then just jimmy it, that usually breaks it loose. So far my ski's not balling up. Nope. Oh, we're ditch banging. Ditch can be fun until all of a sudden a tree's down in the middle of it. Oh, sledder bumps. Deep there. Right here is where I saved my buddy's life. Sled had flipped on him right here, and he was under it for like a good 10 minutes or so. we were up there, me and another guy, we'd circle around several times, found him upside down right there, pinned under his sled, leg poking out, shaking. Said he was about to pass out. It was pinning him down pretty good. What? Another snow biker? Who dat? Classic snow biker move. Not even saying hi. Jumps. You gonna jump the creek? You gonna jump the creek? I know, I can first gear. You're maroon? Right here? There's a little bit of a creek flowing, but you could probably hop.
We'll get it this spring.
Yeah, we can get a helicopter. We could bring a helicopter in. Yeah, like that's the, if you hit that log, aim for this tree. That would have been more spectacular, though. That would be more spectacular. Let me get my phone out. Might be an ice ball. As long as you fall right, you'd be fine. Sounds castle.
King of the castle.
Somewhere I've crossed in here, I've gone up higher and it's easier. I've crossed that log before when there's more snow, the one over there.
Yeah, I think you're on top now. Take a look. Oh, you're right there.
Oh, you're right there.
Nice. Sure. That was steep. Steep climb. Oh, snow is deep in here. Snow is fantastic right here. Yeah. Snowmobilers!